Hey everybody, how's everybody doing? I know I haven't been on for about a month. There's been a lot going on with my part-time job because of the holiday season. So my hours have been extended at night. So basically, I'm working between the hours of 6 p.m. and 11:30 or midnight. So by the time I get home, I am tired. The other thing is, I'm helping a coworker of mine get home. So I'm not even getting home until like 1. But I get really tired and then I go to bed and I'm just like, ugh, I gotta do it all over again. And plus, I'm working an extra day and I've been taking shifts and stuff like that. So I also got a new piercing, but I'll mention that more in another video. I literally just got it a couple days ago, but that's not what this video is about. I've been going through a lot of stuff. Like I said, work's been crazy. Black Friday, I work retail, so my job's been nuts. Boom! It's been nuts. I also went to the party that was hosted by the haunt I volunteer at. That was a lot of fun. But before I get carried away, I wanted to make a story time video. And this is actually probably by far the worst, god-awful, horrible babysitting job I've ever done in my life. And I've babysat a lot before I even started working like a real paying job, part-time, full-time, whatever. Mainly part-time. But before I got my job with this company, I was babysitting, and that's what I did for extra money. So I was maybe about, I want to say 19. I was probably about 19 years old. I was looking for a little bit extra money. I wasn't working yet at my current job, and I just need some extra cash, you know, to buy Christmas gifts or go out to dinner or whatever. So I live in an apartment complex, so basically finding people to babysit for is not difficult. I just made a bunch of signs and I stuck them all in each particular building that I could on a corkboard. And I just said, you know, my name, I'm looking for babysitting work. Here's my name, here's my number, blah, 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 blah. So, I want to say maybe about a week later, again, I was maybe about 18, 19 years old. I got a phone call from a father telling me he was looking for a babysitter for his 3-year-old daughter. And I was like, okay. And at that time, I've never babysat someone that young. I would say about the youngest I babysat at this point was maybe 6 or 7. So 3 was definitely a little much, but I was like, you know, it's extra money, I'll take it, you know, see how it goes. So with this family, there were a bunch of red flags. I wish I caught on to them sooner. I didn't, but I wish I did. The first red flag was this dad was like, well, I have to ask my daughter and see if it's okay. What? Your daughter is 3 years old. You're the parent. You're supposed to be making the choices, not anybody else. You are supposed to be making the choices. That's it. I mean, I understand you want your kid to feel comfortable with the babysitter. I understand that you want them to feel comfortable, but it's overall, you're the parent. You are supposed to be making the choices and stuff like that. Like, it's not up to the kid fully. It's up to you as well. So that was the first red flag. So he called me. He asked me, hey, are you available to babysit on this day? And I was like, yeah, I'm free. So whatever. I was not doing anything. I didn't drive yet or anything like that. So I went to babysit. I met the mom. There were a couple little distinctive differences about this particular couple that were a little odd to me. But I needed them some cash and they needed a babysitter and I had no problem with it. So the first thing that was kind of odd was that the mom was kind of a little strange. And I'll get more into this throughout the story. So the mom was a little odd. Like, more of like the fact of like the mom and Mean Girls, the mother of Regina George, she was like that kind of mom. And she was like 5'2", and she was like Hispanic, and her daughter was half white, half Hispanic. I have friends who are half and half. I have friends who are full. I love everyone. I don't judge or whatever. I love every single human being out here in the planet. I don't judge. I love everybody. Skin tone, sexuality, whatever you are, I'm cool with you. I respect you. I'm cool. So, yeah, so she was a little odd. She was like the mom of Regina George and Mean Girls. Like, she was trying to be that cool, hip mom, like, up with the fashions, stuff like that. So, she was telling me that I guess her and her husband, his name, were going to the casino and they needed a babysitter. I'm like, okay, that's fine, I'll watch her. It's no problem. I'm not gonna say what their names are or anything, or but yeah, I'll make up a name. So the mom's name, we'll call her Rebecca. We'll call her Rebecca. And the daughter's name was Paulina. And the dad's name was Richard. Okay. So the mom, which I already forgot her name, of course, but though the mom, she was kind of a young hip mom. Her daughter, which was 3, who was I was babysitting, they left, and I started watching her. So the first thing that was odd was, I said, "Hey, do you want to watch TV? Do you want to do this? Do you want to do that?" The first thing this kid says to me is, "Babysitter, what are we going to be doing?" And then I tried saying, "Well, you can learn my name." And I told him my name. Obviously, my name is Sarah. So I'm like, "Hey, just call me Sarah, You don't have to call me babysitter or whatever, but you can just call me by my name, Sarah." So, of course, she's 3, so I'm not really expecting her to for it to sink in or whatever. So throughout the night, she starts to get kind of demanding and she starts to get kind of bratty and she wants her way, she wants her juice, she wants this, she wants that, she wants the other thing. And then I'm like, okay, so we'll try to get it done. So that's the first night. The parents came home, I want to say around 2 in the morning, and may I remind you, they left like around 8. 8, what was it? 8, 8 to 9, 9 to 10, 10 to 11. 11 to 12, 12 to 1, 1 to 2. So they were at the casino for a good 6 hours. So that was my first night babysitting. And they paid me after they came home, they paid me. So then I leave, I go back to my building, and I tell my dad how it was and everything the next day. And everything's going well. And then about a couple days later, they call me to babysit again. And I'm like, okay, sounds good to me. So I go to babysit again. Again, the girl is still being kind of bratty. She's still kind of calling me babysitter, and she's just calling me babysitter, and I'm like, I don't really feel comfortable with that. But she's 3, so it's whatever. So then, they came home from the casino again, paid me, sent me on my way. So then, about a month into this, is when things really started getting freaky. So they called me to babysit. I said, okay. I go in, and the mom is wearing a wig. And she already had hair. People like to change up their looks, I understand. But she's wearing a like a wig. Like a interesting kind of wig. Like, I can't explain it without not saying the right term, but she was just wearing a wig. And I'm like, I'm thinking to myself, why is she wearing a wig? Whatever. So then, again, they leave to go to the casino or go out or wherever the hell they're doing. And all of a sudden, the girl starts crying. And I'm like, everything will be okay. You want to watch SpongeBob? Or she called it Spongies because she's 3. She doesn't know any better. So she calls it Spongies. I want to watch Spongies. I'm like, okay, we'll watch Spongies. Do you want anything to drink? You want something to eat? She's like, I want juice. Okay. Being kind of demanding for a 3-year-old. Okay. So that was interesting. And then apparently, the next time after that, the dad went to do something and the mom went to do something else. I forget what they were doing, but they weren't together. They were separate doing their own thing. So it's about maybe about 11, 12 o'clock at night, and the dad comes home first, and I guess the child, she wants chocolate or she wants strawberries or something like that. And she starts crying, like she's like begging her dad to have chocolate or whatever, and it's late. And her dad's like, no, you can't have any. But he's not saying it in the right appropriate way for the first time, I guess you could say. Like, he's just full on screaming at her. And I could tell something wasn't right with him because I can tell he had a little bit too much to drink. Basically, he had a little bit too much to drink. And he was kind of wobbly or tipsy or whatever. So I could tell that. So then, the weird thing is, he didn't pay me and he sent me on my way, which I thought was very odd, but I kept track of my hours. So I messaged him the next day and I was like, hey, I worked this time to this time. Just let me know when you have the money. And I kid you not, 3 days later, he paid me. And this is when it started getting like really weird because I was like, what, 3 days later? So then, by the way, this job took about like 6 months. Just saying. So then, again, it's Christmas time. It's rolling around. The parents don't want to necessarily bring the kid because they don't want to know what they're buying her, which I completely understand. So I remember one day, the mom messages me. She's like, hey, can you come babysit? I have to go do some Christmas shopping, and she doesn't want to go. And, I do what she says. And I'm like, you're doing it? Wait, what? That doesn't necessarily sound right, but okay. So basically, the reason why the mom needed me was because the kid didn't want to go to the mall or shopping or whatever. And I'm like, okay, that's a little weird, but okay. So this is maybe about 8, maybe 9 in the morning. About, yeah, 8 or 9 in the morning. So it's about 8 or 9 in the morning. I'm there until literally around 12, 1. And then she comes home and she is like, okay, well, you can go home and take a shower or whatever, eat, and then I need you to come back at like 3. And I'm like, what? I'm doing a double? Like, what the hell? Like, you're not even paying me enough to be doing a double. And I wasn't really even making that much, but still, like, a double? Like, 8 to 2, and well, 8 to 1, and then 3 to God knows whatever. Like, what? So then, literally, I do the second shift or whatever, and the guy pays me 4 days later, and it's just like, what? No, this got really weird. So then, basically, as December of that year went on, I think that was like 2012. Then they expected me to do housework while I watched their kid. And they were going to pay me less to do housework and to watch their kid at the same time. And after this, I was getting pretty fed up because I'm like, what the hell? So, for the fact is, your kid basically controls you and you have to go by her for everything when she's 3 years old. Two, you're a wacky because you're like not working. And the dad's doing all the work, and that's probably, you're not even paying me when you're supposed to be paying me. You're paying me like 3, 4, 5 days later. So that was really odd to me. And I told them because January came after December, obviously, and I said, okay, so my birthday is on this day, so I'm gonna go out and celebrate with my friends. I told them, I was like, okay, yep, I'm going out this day, it's my birthday. On my birthday, when I'm already out, they freaking call me to babysit. And I'm like, yeah, it's my birthday. I'm already celebrating. So for the fact that they just didn't give a shit and they called me anyway to babysit on my birthday when I already told them it's my birthday, I'm celebrating, is like, what the hell? So basically, after that, I was just so fed up. I was done. And it gets weirder too. Like, this kid kept calling me babysitter. Like, she wouldn't call me by my name. She'd call me babysitter. Like, basically, like I was like beneath her. And I'm like, she's 3 years old. Like, what the hell? And she, like, basically, she's calling me babysitter, babysitter, babysitter. She wasn't calling me by my name. I understand you're three, but my name's a lot shorter than the word babysitter. But it was basically like, you know, I was beneath her or whatever. And I remember once I went out to my friend's house and they called me, and just to get out of it, because I didn't feel like doing it, because I was so fed up with all their bullshit, because they kept coming home intoxicated. You know, they were not a good couple together. Like, they fought a lot. The dad was a miserable person. And, like, you know, it was just not a good scene. It was not horrible. And, like I said, again, you don't pay me 4 or 5 days later. You should pay me at the most a day later, if not the night before, the night when you come home. And if you need to plan your money, you have to plan your money. I understand. But there's always an ATM going on or whatever. So I went to a friend's house and they called me to babysit. I pretended I was sick so I wouldn't have to do it because I was so fed up with their bullshit. And I never got a call from them ever again. And the funny thing is, I don't think they really live in my apartment complex anymore. But the moral of the story is, be careful who you babysit for, because you don't know exactly like who you're dealing with unless you've known them for a long time, or unless you've known them at all for a while. And in my case, I was 19 years old. I needed some money. All I had was babysitting experience, and that's what I can get at the time. But I will admit I did make some pretty decent money off while babysitting for them. But it was just the fact that the kid had all the control, the parents had no control. I was hired as a babysitter. They were trying to get me to do actual housework, like their laundry, their vacuuming, their cleaning, and they were literally gonna pay me less than when I was just their babysitter. So basically, I was gonna do all the house cleaning and babysitting, and I was gonna get paid less for it. And after that, I was like, fuck this shit. I'm done. I don't want to do it. I don't care to do it. I don't see a point in doing it. I think it's stupid. So I got fed up and I just stopped answering. They stopped calling me and I don't know where they are since, but I can just tell you I feel bad for that little girl because, you know, her parents were not a good match together and she learned a lot of bad habits at the age of 3. But anyway, that's the story. My moral story again is, be careful who you're babysitting for. You don't know who they are until you really know them. And they could always seem nice, but they always have like a hidden agenda underneath something. So that's my story. I know I haven't been on much the past month. I've been busy with works and stuff like that, but I'm gonna be making more videos as soon as the Christmas season is done with my job. And I hope to hear from you guys soon. Leave a comment in the description below if you ever had a bad job, whether it's babysitting, retail, food, whatever. Leave a comment. Subscribe to my channel. I only have like 2 subscribers, and I know that, but I want to get to know you guys as much as I know you want to get to know me. So leave a comment, like, and subscribe, and maybe we can get to this video to be about 5 likes. We'll start with 5 likes just to make it simple. 5 likes. All right, guys, have a good evening. Peace. Love you guys. Bye.